Where's my empanada? I got no empanada in my bag. Oh, there it is. All right.
Have you ever been hated or discriminated against? I have. I've been protested and demonstrated against. I was respected on both sides of the political scheme, like a progressive Taco Bell double-decker taco supreme. Then one night a vision came to me in a dream, a zany sitcom at the White House on the TV screen. I had to give myself a hand at the band I had planned for it. Holland, Elfman, Gavin, Pullman, he's a big league brand. I was our generation's Norman Lear, and this was my opus. Once the pundits could see it, I'd rake in plenty of dough. Thus, just imagine my surprise at all the lies that these guys from People, TV Guide, Variety, the LA Times tried to tell about my show. They said if you watch 1600 Penn, it'll make you never want to watch your TV again. But what hurt the most was when I heard Obama say, "This was your worst idea since Monterey."
I'm sorry, Obama. I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry. So tonight, I'm back inside my closet. I said, sorry, Obama.
Seriously, John?
I never meant to hurt you.
It's spinach and artichoke.
I never meant to make you cry. So tonight, I'm back inside my closet.
You don't need a new name.
I got a rich history of closet activity, and though I confide that I had to decide to stop denying it at 17 and threw it all by the wayside with all that implied, it ain't been a joyride. Let's go back to 1993, before I ever tried to get this fucking show on TV. We took a fateful trip to Hooters. As I sat at the table, I shot my dad a look that said, "Get me out if you're able." Then flash forward, and I'm watching Kelsey Grammer and co. And I'm thinking that one day this kid could have his own show. I'm watching Frasier for days, my eyes are glazed, they're fixed to the screen. I study the ways that they play with their verbal melee and essay every scene. The brilliant display of their banter and wit are a part of my DNA, but I'm only human, and my dream would only bring me dismay. What I did was stupid. I was naive to think I'd ever reach the heights of what the cranes had achieved, but when Barack came in and told me that he hated my show, I swear I've never felt so low.
I'm sorry, Obama. I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry. So tonight, I'm back inside my closet. I said, sorry, Obama. I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry. So tonight, I'm back inside my closet.
So now I've ditched my ambition, I found a new competition. I'm playing Breath of the Wild, sitting on the floor of my kitchen. I got my lox piled high, the bagel, cinnamon, raisin. Gotta get my 6 to 10 servings of carbohydrates a day, son. Then I hear a lock turning and I know what's in store. The golden boy himself, Ronan Farrow, opens the door. He's got a closet full of Pulitzers, his plaudits are legion, while I can't keep a sitcom on the air for more than one season. I'm an interesting person, I take 30 minutes tops to get myself out of an escape room, can't keep me in that box. I invent new earthquake measures on a linear scale, while I shill for sheets and shams in both sateen and percale. I'll fuck up Lachlan Murdoch, name the time and the place where I can give that dick a fair and balanced punch to his face. But Ronan gets the book deals, he's the one who gets praise, while I'll be making Simply Safe ads for the rest of my days. I got Dangerfield levels of disrespect, but when I look at Ronan, he keeps saying, "What do you expect?" I ask what he means, he says 1600 Penn, so I guess it's time to go back in the closet again.
I'm sorry, Ronan. I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry. So tonight, I'm back inside my closet.
One more time!
I said, I'm sorry, Ronan. I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry. So tonight, I'm back inside my closet.
Hey, can someone get me an oat milk? I'm feeling a little parched. But, no, skim is not an acceptable substitute. Skim milk is disgusting. Shame on you for getting skim milk. Skim milk is terrible. It's terrible. It's not good for you. It's not healthier. It doesn't taste better. It's stupid. Skim milk is a vengeful scam from the low-fat era of the fucking food pyramid. It's gotta go. It's gotta go.
Thank you. Hey, it's Paul. I don't know how you fucking managed to do it, but now you've got five guys on my ass. You've got the FDA on my ass now about this fucking food pyramid thing. You better know what the fuck you're doing.